been locked down somewhere in Las Vegas. It's the Free For All After Dark with Sean Tempesta.
Damn it.
I'll clean it later.
Welcome to the show.
Question was asked whether or not Michelle will join for today's show. You heard her cackle. Yes, well, she will.
Cackle! Wow, and the hits keep coming.
They certainly do. It's great to see you all. Hi, I'm Sean. I'm going to be your host for this lovely disgrace that is the Free For All. Let's go around the horn. We have a full house tonight. First of all, Kira. How you
That's
doing?
True. I'm doing so great. I'm in a great mood today, and I have so much energy. I'm so excited and so happy.
I liked you better when you were borderline depressed yesterday, so this is going again.
I hate you.
Right. Oh, man. Also with us, hi, everybody. Look who finally showed up. Michelle Pearson.
Hello, me. Dinner at Fleming's was fabulous. Thanks for asking.
Just saying, like, you know, it's,
I don't think he cared.
I have a text from, okay, this is a text from Michelle, okay?
Okay, let me explain, though.
No,
go
let me
ahead,
read,
do your
let me
damn
read this text,
text
okay? Because you were a liar.
Because I said
you're
we were just walking up. No.
You're a lying liar that lies. This is from, let's see.
Go ahead, read
okay,
it.
Okay, here we go. Wanna, 433. Sure, exclamation point. Yay. That all happened at 4:33 and 4:34. 6:50. I'm sorry. I had dinner with my mom.
Had dinner. Yes.
Just leaving now. We don't want to hear you, Michelle. Wow. Just leaving now. Won't be home until a little after 7. I'm sorry. I'll be a little late.
So what constitutes a little?
That is a little.
Needed,
3 days.
That is a frick. You could drive a truck through that. Meanwhile, if her daughter was that late for an appointment that she was supposed to be at, she would whoop her ass so hard. Speaking of that, you can't see it, but your lower third says you're a stuffed animal inverter.
Ooh.
It's not incorrect, is it?
How has your day been, Sean?
Dark lipstick. That is a brave move.
It works, though. I think it works.
I don't know. It just it kind of comes off a little aggressive. Got to be honest. I think it fits your personality. Who am I to say I'm just a man? But I'm just saying, you know, it seems a little much. Doesn't seem a little much.
It seems a little much, yes.
Death to Gilbert. Oh, my God.
Oh, it's okay, wow. Gilbert. It's just fine.
Oh,
we were looking at your family members in parking spots a couple of days ago. We'll get to that in just a second. Hey, Nancy's here. Here's the king. How are you, Nick? It's good to
Hi, guys.
See you.
Good to see, well, I see me, but good to hear you.
Oh, I'm here.
Good to see you too.
You might be the king again. I mean, the way things are going, we had Sarah qualified again yesterday, so she now has a natural, unbought double dong immunity. It's very interesting.
So happy for her.
Yeah, it's very exciting. Very exciting.
Done good.
You know, it's great. It's great to see you. You're a lovely person. Evan Stefan couldn't join us tonight. He's going to see Space Jam with LeBron James, which is not worth the stuff. Ken Banch, great question. What is this month's charity, King?
I didn't want to say it too early. I mean, because somebody still could get too qualified.
Sure. Mm-hmm. I mean, but you know, you put it out there and then maybe people will feel bad if it's a charity they like.
Okay. Olive Crest.
Very good.
For the kids.
For those of it is for the kids.
And more than them.
Child adoption. It's safe homes for children that are neglected and abused. They've been around since the 70s. A great organization. They've been on the TV show several times. I love that. You're a beautiful man. I want you to know that.
I try. I kind of piggyback the idea from Smart and Final. because earlier this month they were doing donations for Olive Crest too. So
you know what? Good for them for actually saying it, because there's some grocery stores you walk in and like you swipe the card and you've given them your number. It's like, oh, would you like to donate $5 for sick kids? I'm like,
I mean, where's it going? His name?
Joey? Like, you know, is there an organization here? It's like, oh, yeah. it's the insert name of the grocery store here foundation. I'm like, no.
No. It's my kid. He's sick at home, you know.
Yeah. Are you gonna help hungry people? You know how much freaking food you just threw out today because the expiration? Come on, please. Stop. Speaking of beautiful people, oh my goodness, there he is with a way more headroom than I need. Will Dorsey.
There is a lot.
So, well, are we keeping you up? Huh? Are we keeping you up? You look a little tired there, fella.
I mean, no, you're never keeping me up.
Okay. Curiosity, I tried tagging you on Twitter, and your Twitter is not there anymore. CL Making Moves, not there on Twitter. What are you hiding from?
I'm not hiding or from who? Anything, Sean.
The world.
Are you worried that somebody's going to see all the stuff you tweet? And that you've taken it offline. Is that what this is? Then why? No. Why? What is it?
I mean, so all of my other social had actually gotten deactivated, but then I actually needed it to go live for a few things. So that's the only reason why some of that is back on right now. But I'm making changes.
Where in the world? Will Dorsey.
He's on the way.
Still don't know. He's right here.
He's on the way.
I'm on the show.
I know, but I still don't know where he is. In the
world mentally.
Will Dorsey.
Sean, I am so excited to see you.
I'm great. I'm excited to see you. You're a beautiful man and a lovely person. I love the artwork you've added to your home.
Even with the forehead. Wow. Wow.
Does my forehead have to do with anything?
Oh no.
Wow.
I love your smile. Yeah, even the gums.
That was a really good comeback. I'm not gonna lie. That was excellent.
That was a good one.
Thanks. Sure. I mean, you know, listen, we're all gonna make fun of physical things we can't help. He's always been here. He's just a little late, I guess. I don't know. It's great to see you. I just don't understand what's going on.
It's great to see you.
Thanks.
You know what? I saw that you had a wonderful vacation. Considering
that this is all you take me for is a man with a forehead.
Oh, your forehead. Oh, yeah. I mean, it's nice. It's nice.
It's there.
It's nice.
On to the next
Hey, everyone.
I only lifted him up. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great. Happy.
Are you prepared that one of those posters probably going to be coming down? The offseason is here, and they're talking about some big names that could no longer be with the team. I'm hearing Riley Smith, maybe Fleury.
I know. I
want to have like an England and then a Belmar poster still up there.
If you get up on Francisco's wall, you're the next to go. It's bananas. It's just very sad. Vadim Shipachev, he had 5 posters on the wall. That's why you never saw him play. Very sad.
People have voodoo dolls. He's got a voodoo wall, apparently.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, who is this? How did you get a Friday off?
Well, I finally have a weekend sports guy now, and for all the 6-day weeks that I've been doing throughout the month of June, I finally was able to get a couple of Fridays off. So,
right.
And I wanted to spend it with all of you.
He messaged me, he's like, hey, by the way, I am free if you need me. I'm like, sure, absolutely. I'd love to have Alex Opario give some legitimacy to the production.
It's a real pros in
here. God knows, I don't give any legitimacy.
Yeah, when you show up.
Finally, was amazing. Thank you.
He just ended, finished his stream. He's like, yeah, sure. What's another? He's trying to clean the land.
Hell yeah.
Mods of the Free For All channel. How are you, sir?
Doing good. Actually, I'm modding, I guess.
Oh, that's good. Not a lot of people to mod. You know, I've come to realize that I just put too much effort into the show. And if I just didn't give so much of a, I'd have about 150 people. Or if I had... then I would have 150 people.
Just write people's names on your arm and stuff without a shirt on.
In a hot tub,
You know what? Here's what I'll do. Maybe I'll shave my legs and I'll put on like a little frilly like underwear. So all you'll see is legs, and you'll just think, oh, that must be some like thick girl. And then write your name on my thighs, and then you know, profit. Right?
That's good. I really want to flip you off for that. That was me.
I know. Well, you still have got to do your hot tub. You have to do your hot tub stream.
Nobody wants to see obesity in a bathing suit.
Come on now.
She didn't say that you were
Crystal,
going to do it.
Crystal,
here's what you do. You
Crystal
name the channel.
Was a hell of a lot thinner.
You name the channel Crystal Palace.
Oh my God.
Just skating rink?
The hot tub. You're we'll just say MILF in a hot tub, and then you're just going to write things all over your body and other things.
Ryan.
Hi, Ryan.
Can I be MILF in a hot tub? And people send biddies. Wait, I'm not done.
And
I was like, I'm not dealing with this.
It's money. Nope. Do you care? My poor father. Dad, I'm sorry. My poor dad.
He loves me.
You want to find it ironic that the one with the stuffed animal on her head is apologizing for her mother?
You know, I'm just living my best life.
She's living her best.
Sure.
I'm sorry.
Sure.
Yeah, I totally.
You know, it's okay. When I go back to school in like 2 weeks, Gilbert will take a break.
God,
why? You're not going to bring him with you?
I'm going to bring him with me.
Like, story.
Oh.
Yes. And he's going
to
be stuck.
There was your chance to put him down the garbage disposal machine.
Yeah, I know. Oh, just a bunch of stuffing out of your sink. That'll be great. William Taiwi. Yo, Sean, look up the Joe Show on Instagram. While Joe is on the air with Ashley and the producers, Mojo in the Morning jumps in on the show in the morning on the radio. It's so funny.
What?
Okay.
I'll look into it. Thanks, William. Okay.
What?
Okay.
I feel like that needed some punctuation.
What would we do without William Taiwi? Seriously.
He's a lovely person.
I'm so lost.
I read that.
Bismarcky
is
no longer of this planet, unfortunately.
I did get to see him in concert once.
Suffered a stroke last year and passed away at the age of 57. I played Just a Friend at the end of my show today. Had type 2 diabetes. He's been in a diabetic coma. A lot of issues. And unfortunately, he passed. But there we go. He's that freaking song, man. You hear that song, you're like, okay. Yeah, this is going to be a good day.
Oh, baby, you.
Oh, baby, you. It's freaking great.
Did you guys get to hear the fun third verse that he did when he was in concert?
No.
You got a disease.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You say it's just a rash. It's crawling
up your ass. Oh, I love that.
Beautiful.
Let's hear it. There's a Bismarcky soundboard. That can't be it, right? No. I'm trying to find if there's like any like little hotkeys I can have for Bismarcky. Sound board? Anyone? Nothing? Nothing. That's unfortunate. But yeah, no, it was a great song. And I don't know any other songs he's done, though. I only know him for the one.
No. Yeah.
But still.
But it's a good one.
He made me happy.
I thought he had two hits. He only had one?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
First hit,
what
my
was
fist
the other
in your
one?
Face. The next hit, your face on the floor. No. Okay, next.
Wow.
Hey, yes. Everybody. Hey. Yes. Hey, I'm sick of things being closed. I'm sick of wearing masks. It's so inconvenient. Hey, I know what we're going to do. We're going to open up the Golden Knights games. Has a guy that takes off his shirt, screaming a bunch of people's faces. And then we're just going to pretend like everything's fine. YOLO. Hey, no one's wearing a mask at the game. YOLO. Hey, they suggest you wear a mask if you have not been vaccinated. Only about 40% of the people are vaccinated. But YOLO. No one's wearing a mask. Guess what, everybody? Yeah, fucked up because the numbers are through the roof. And Las Vegas and Clark County, number one in the nation when it comes to new infections. Great job. You did it, everybody. Southern Nevada Health District coming out saying, you know what? Yeah, this is not working out very well. Positivity rates around 11%. Health officials recommending everyone wear masks in crowded indoor public places, regardless of status. They said Friday that both vaccinated and unvaccinated people should wear masks in places where they may have contact with people who are not fully vaccinated. In other words, everywhere. And here's the problem is that there's some breakthrough stuff that's happening with the Delta variant in particular, where even if you are vaccinated, you might get sick. And yeah, sure, you might not get that sick because you were vaccinated, but then you pass it on to somebody who wasn't vaccinated and they get really sick, and then we just keep doing this until it morphs into 19 other freaking versions. The summer's rise in cases and positivity rates cited as the reason. The masks used correctly have been proven to be an effective thing for stopping the spread. There was something I saw. So 51% of the total population considered at least partially vaccinated, 43.1% fully vaccinated. Most of the 700 people in the hospital right now are not vaccinated. So obviously
that's what I wanted to know if it was in there. Yeah. My cousin was telling us that everyone in the hospital hasn't been vaccinated yet.
As I understand, you know, I don't want to, it's not really a big surprise, but, oh, by the way, somebody has noticed the size of your microphone. Revenge of the Chaz is very impressed by the size of your microphone, sir.
Okay.
Nice. But nice, the Golden Mike. Knights game, that I mean, Garth Brooks are going to find out is probably going to be a big spread too. But that last Golden Knights game where they they just like gave up. But there was a massive spreader event. Some 30-something-year-old died. Unvaccinated 30-something-year-old died, believes that he contracted it. Or the family believes he contracted it at the Golden Knights game. A lot of people getting sick at the Golden Knights game. DJ Joe Green got sick, who's, you know, healthier than I am. He's a handsome fella. He could probably see his own wiener. I can't do that right now. All right. He got wheeled out on a wheelchair from the hospital with COVID. So, yeah, we're just like.
What the fuck does that? What does that mean?
What does what mean?
Oh, boy.
He can see his own wiener?
Well, what I'm saying is
that a thing. That is absolutely a thing.
That's the thing that she takes from this.
That is
the only thing she took from that.
This is, wait. Yeah, so, okay,
hold on. You can't see their ding-ding. I don't have one, so I wouldn't know.
If you're big enough and you're small enough,
can't see
it. It's the belly.
It's a bad ratio.
Yeah, it hangs over.
Going on.
Yeah.
This concerns me. Gabriel Iglesias, Fluffy, just got sick with COVID and had to cancel the rest of his shows in San Antonio. Canceled his Netflix special. He was That's vaccinated, terrifying. According to Revenge of the Chaz. And this is the thing. This is starting to become, because the vaccination was made for the original version of the virus. Mm-hmm. And now it keeps, every time it mutates, it gets a little bit off that beaten path. Guys, I know we don't like vaccinations. We don't want the government telling us what to do. It's trying to put the things in our hands. Oh, they tested it on animals, but they stopped because all the animals died. You're morons. Enough with this. Enough.
Wow, Sean.
This is gonna keep going.
Sean,
this is going. I'm sorry. This is going to keep going. Yeah. I understand it. You don't feel comfortable with the vaccine, then wear the mask. Always wear it everywhere. Because this is gonna keep spreading, and we're gonna keep living with this until we either all freaking get it, or we all freaking get in line and start realizing, oh wait. Maybe we should be like we were when we were in fifth grade and maybe listen to scientists and not think of them as like they're morons. You know, like, I don't know what this anti-science thing is, but it's freaking lame. It's so lame. One thing to remember, no vaccine's 100%. The efficacy rate is 90%. That means 10 will still get sick. Yes, and that was for the original strain, which means there's other strains. Yeah. So if you walk into a room with all vaccinated people, it's like 10 of them, you have COVID. One of them statistically may get COVID. Statistically. But no guarantee. The Delta variant has a higher infection rate. 90%, a great number. The flu vaccine is less than 50%. It is, but still, This kills at a higher rate than the flu. So, and now it's, you know, when it kills a freaking 30-year-old that's in pretty decent health that had a kid, I understand there's a lot of, I know friends of mine, they're around my age, are like, I don't need it. It's like, I know you're probably going to be fine if you get it, but like, we all have to freaking chip in. We all are sitting at the table, chip in for the bill. I'm not going to pay for this myself. That's essentially what I'm saying.
Yeah. What's frustrating is it's literally a miracle that they came up with this so quickly. And with such efficiency, and the fact that people are still unwanting to, you need to get a meningitis vaccine to go to college. Yeah. You need to get like 60 vaccines to go to the military. You need to get all of your other vaccines just to go to public school. I don't know, what is it about this one, other than the fact that it was made quickly, even though the technology for it has been worked on for 7 or 8 years, they just happened to switch their attention to this particular virus. I just don't understand where the anti-science stuff comes from and the anti-vaccine thing comes from, because you need to, there's government requirements for all kinds of different things.
Yeah. It's you know, it's not the government requiring, but like if your kid goes to school, yeah, they're going to have to get vaccinated. As soon as this is not emergency use authorization, they're going to make your kid get it, and you're going to have to deal with it like all the other ones.
Science makes me feel dumb.
Should I read the Carl Sagan quote from yesterday again? Because that's a freaking winner. Did you hear the Carl Sagan quote from yesterday's show? Yeah, that's right. You were at dinner. Let me read this for you really fast.
Fleming's was delicious.
Carl,
thank you.
Sagan. This is from Carl Sagan's book back in 1995, one of the last things he ever wrote. I have a foreboding. Okay, let me know if this reminds you of anything. I have a foreboding of an America in my children or grandchildren's time, when the United States is a service and information economy, when nearly all the manufacturing industries have slipped away to other countries, when awesome technological powers are in the hands of very few, when no one representing the public interest can even grasp the issues. When the people have lost the ability to set their own agendas or knowingly question those in authority. Okay. It is like he's the Tupac of scientists.
He wrote this
exactly. Yesterday. He's the Tupac of scientists. Okay.
Like 1984.
When clutching our crystals and nervously consulting our horoscopes, our critical faculties in decline, unable to distinguish between what feels good and what's true, we slide almost without noticing back into superstition and darkness.
Seriously, when did he write this?
1995.
Okay, I thought that's what you said. Wow, this is wild. Okay.
The dumbing down of America is most evident in the slow decay of substantive content in the enormously influential media, the 30-second soundbites now down to 10 seconds or less, the lowest common denominator programming. Hi.
Well, yeah.
that's me. Credulous presentations on pseudoscience and superstition, but especially a kind of celebration of ignorance.
Wow.
Tell me that isn't on the nose right now. It's like unbelievable.
Yeah.
You have like groups of people applauding that no one's getting the vaccine. It's like, you're morons. Literally, if we can stop this from spreading, the virus isn't alive. It's alive when it's in us. So if it goes nowhere, it dies and it doesn't come back. That's the way it works. Like measles, pretty much eradicated until stupid anti-vaxxers. They're like, no, I'm not going to do it with my kids. And then all of a sudden, measles freaking outbreaks out of nowhere. Like, we got to keep this thing in a freaking thing. The movie Idiocracy, according to Revenge of the Chaz, has come true faster than predicted in that satire. Society, knowledge, and common sense degrading so fast it's scary. It's the truth. It is really like it was 490 years too early or too late.
Yeah. I'm actually waiting for that to happen, because then I could possibly be the smartest person on earth. So
that'd be amazing. you could play that role, I think, pretty well too. I think you kind of seem like just Joe regular dude. So long story short, listen, masks, no one likes wearing masks. They suck.
Absolutely.
But we've got to. We're probably going to have to. They're not going to force us initially, just like they did last time, and no one's going to wear them. And then all of a sudden, you're going to get forced to wear them. Because that's the way it is. But
I got so used to not wearing them, I didn't realize, I guess, that they the mandates were never lifted as far as in like medical settings. I had a doctor appointment on Monday. Yeah. I walked right in with no mask on. I'm like, I had to go run to my car, get
medical
my mask.
Medical settings and the airport. Yep.
But I'm like so used to, you know, walking into Albertsons and not wearing one, but no one's around me in Albertsons. We're not close. The Garth Brooks concert was a little scary.
Oh my God. It's a ton of people. You were at the Garth Brooks concert too. It was a madhouse.
Yep. Yeah. 68,000 people.
Yeah. Of your closest friends that you've never met. I'm just, this is, you know, Cameron, the guy that runs around that at the Golden Knights games, and he's the one who takes off his shirts and he throws them into the audience. He was in the audience, remember, during that last game. Who did I go? Who was with me that last game?
I went to that game, but...
Oh, you went to that game.
Was it the one where he wiped the sweat on his head with the guy that was in front of us?
May have been. But he also was screaming directly in people's faces, like, yeah! And then, like, they'd scream back, and then he would just do that in the next section. So, I mean, I'm not calling him a super spreader, but it's a little too soon to be spiking that football.
That's a lot, yeah.
68,000 people?
At Garth Brooks.
Yep.
If you do the math, that's like 40,000 people that are that could possibly be infected with COVID. 40,000 people.
It won't be that high, but it will still definitely... It will still definitely go up. Brandy's saying, my husband just got over COVID. I have a friend of mine whose wife just got COVID. I tested negative twice. I just saw a map.
Yep.
We by far have the hottest spot right now in the nation. And there's not a lot of vaccination going on here. We're among the lowest in the country. So yeah, it's time to start waking up and using our brains.
I read that it could be spotted in a chest x-ray, which I don't entirely understand, but I don't know anything about
it. So here's what happens is if it gets to your lungs,
got a chest x-ray for my checkup on Monday. So yay, here's hoping I don't have it.
Nice. my biggest pet peeve is that people are complaining that the flu rate dropped last year, but they don't want to accept the fact that people were wearing their masks, washing their hands, and social distancing. That's why it happened. Yeah, exactly.
Yes, so, nobody got
COVID. Of course that's why it happened. No one left their house.
10% equals 6,800 people infected. So yeah, let's say half the place was not vaccinated and half was. The half that were vaccinated, 10% of those people would likely possibly get it if you were near them. Whatever the case is, just enough. Like, I get it. We're all put down. I didn't wear my mask at the Golden Knights games when it wasn't required anymore. But now we're starting to realize, maybe we're going to have to do this a little bit longer than we need to do. I just want to keep everything open. I don't want to close anything. If I have to wear a mask, then let's wear a friggin' mask. I'll eat on a patio, not for the next 3 months because it's too friggin' hot, but I will. And we'll just get through it together. Okay, on to more topics that are things and stuff. Dictionary.com, which is a fake dictionary. It's not the real one. But they're cute. They like to add new words. They added more than 300 new words.
Oh my God. I heard about one today.
Whoa.
They added yeet.
Oh yeah.
They did add yeet.
Yeah, my son was so excited yeet. About yeet.
That's done. I don't know. Like, because I hear the use of the word yeet that I've heard is different than how they have it here. Like yeet as in like you just yeeted off a cliff.
I've heard
yeet in the traffic.
Yeet started with the chick that threw the Coke can down the hallway at school. She yeeted it. Yeah. But my son also uses it when he's excited about something. We're going to WWE.
Yes.
Yeet.
I also heard that yeet was like you eat or like have you eaten? You eat.
Yeet. Yeet. Yeet.
What are you, a redneck?
Jeff Foxworthy.
The dumbing down of America is the most evident in the slow decay of substantive so yeet is an exclamation of enthusiasm, approval, triumph, pleasure, joy, etc. In the dictionary.com.
Yeet.
Zaddy.
Oh,
Zaddy.
No.
Zaddy?
Oh, no.
Zaddy, an attractive man who is also stylish, charming, and self-confident. I would like to be a Zaddy.
It's a fashionable daddy. Yeah, I get it.
Fashionable, yeah. A snack, slang term, a sexy and physically attractive person, a hottie. A snack. This one I'm surprised wasn't there, because I'm pretty sure I've played this in Words with Friends. Oof. An exclamation used to sympathize with someone else's pain or dismay, or to express one's own.
I use that all the time.
All the time.
Yeah. Brandon uses that.
There's yeah. other ones here.
That's
too.
An onomatopoeia, isn't it? Isn't that the
Is that what that's
Sorry,
called?
Sorry, English major. I think so.
Onomatopoeia is a word that's like the sound. It's a word like that's essentially the sound butter. That you make.
Yeah, exactly. That's, no, that's, yeah. That's what oof
I don't
is.
Think it's oof. I don't like think oof is onomatopoeia because you're like, I don't know.
You
know.
If you get like punched in the stomach, air comes out.
Oof. Good evening.
Yeah. I guess
What's
maybe.
Up, Jay Abner?
Yeah.
Good evening.
Maybe.
English lesson for
What
me.
Evening?
Jedi was added to the dictionary.com. Yeah.
Like Star Wars Jedi?
What's the meaning of that?
Justice, equity, diversity, and inclusion, a conceptual framework that attempts to redress disparity and inequality in society. So, you know, the Jedi's, Aunt Jemima is added in there as a slang term, a black woman considered by other black people to be subservient or to curry favor with white people, like an Uncle Ben or is it Uncle Tom. Uncle Tom, they would say.
Uncle Tom.
Uncle
yeah.
Tom was that's essentially the female Uncle Tom. So.
So basically, you're taking my favorite syrup and you're stomping on it. That's
well, the
a
favorite
stupid
syrup
definition.
Doesn't exist anymore. You know that, right? Aunt Jemima.
I know.
She's gone.
You know that I saved our last bottle because I just.
You're weird.
I'm not getting rid of it because I'm weird, so I saved it.
Okay, fair.
She is weird.
It'll be worth one day.
It could be just like Pokemon cards,
just
like Mario 64.
Maybe not.
Mario 64. Jabber, Uncle Ben was the rice guy. True. Well, I mean, if Aunt Jemima would be, then you'd think Uncle Ben would get in there too. Come on now.
But it's not subservient. It's just good syrup. Just
I understand.
Making everything
syrup,
so freaking negative.
No, because the imagery was based upon old tropes. That's why it's not less the name and more of the imagery that was kind of like, if you look at the older advertising, it was very like, oh yes, sir, let me get you. Like, it was just a lot of that. And it's not good.
The way that he talked in Driving Miss Daisy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It does not age well. No.
I know.
Ken Banch, WWE SummerSlam is going to be a huge super spreader as well. Market. Sean Tempesta, who just gave away tickets earlier on the show. Market won't be at 100% capacity. Market.
August 21st.
I'm kind of hoping not.
Market.
Kind of hoping not.
Okay. Next story.
Hayden and I are sitting in the nosebleeds.
You might be wondering, as long as
who are we?
As long as COVID doesn't rise, you'll be fine. NASA, the moon has wobbled in orbit. A moon wobble in orbit may lead to record flooding on Earth. Every coast of the U.S. is facing rapidly increasing tide floods. NASA says this is due to a wobble in the moon's orbit working in tandem with climate change fueled rising sea levels. New study from NASA and the University of Hawaii warns that upcoming changes in the moon's orbit could lead to record flooding on Earth in the next decade. Flooding thresholds and astronomical cycles. Researchers found flooding in American coastal cities could be several multiples worse in the 2030s when the next moon wobble is expected to begin. They expect the flooding to significantly damage infrastructure in displaced communities. The last wobble or the first was in 1728, at least the first time was reported. It's responsible for periods of both higher and lower tides about every 18 and a half years. They aren't dangerous in their own right. However, high tides are lower than normal, low tides are higher than normal. In the other half of the cycle, tides are amplified, which means if you have rising sea levels and you also have a wobble, you get yourself a really up day. So congratulations, everyone. Doesn't it feel like everything's kind of right now? It just feels like everything's screwy.
Yeah, a little bit.
What is money? You know, nothing makes sense anymore. Okay. Proving that radio is a powerful medium. And we go to William Tyuee. William Tyuee, hey, yo, bruh, listen. This is a Chicago DJ doing something amazing. Radio personality Ray Stevens raised money to fix the truck of Braxton Mays, 20-year-old, after learning he walks several miles to and from work every day. Let me find the video here. Doesn't he have it here? There's a GoFundMe page. Boom. And my new guy. Let's see here. Here it is. All right, here we go.
So, got up really early this morning to be on Fox and Friends, national TV. Out of New York with my friend Braxton, my new guy.
Can I just say, by the way, this freaking guy's voice is amazing. Amazing. I love good radio voice. Continuing.
I think I'm going to have to take Braxton to Foxfire and have a dinner and get to know this guy. Maybe take his whole family. He's a good guy.
Aww.
earlier this year, I decided that it was time to make a change, whether that be professionally or physically. As of today,
he went with physically. Like a suckling pig.
You're down 30 pounds.
Hey, good for him.
The professional thing's coming.
Okay.
All right.
Chicago, 9:40 with one of my favorite, most spiritual, uplifting people in the world, Sylvia Perez. We'll see you then. With Braxton.
Okay, so there's that. Hold on a second. It's with Braxton. But here's the, do we have a video of Braxton or no? So we'll go, no. I don't think we have video of Braxton here, but we'll go to this picture right here. Thanks to Fox and Friends telling the story. Is it here or no? Maybe there isn't a video of it here. It appears as though there is not. Let's go over to here then. We'll go to the fundraiser. He was trying to raise money. Many of you know me. I was on my way home from work Friday to see a young man walking down Kirk Road. I dropped my friend off at the studio and work out of and headed home. This young man was still walking, so I drove around the block and asked him if he needed a ride. In our town, we help people out. He was hesitant, but he got in. I mean, you should be hesitant. Hey, fella, right. You like a ride with me?
Yeah.
No, that's okay. I'm not going to try to touch your... I'm just trying to be nice. You know, it's in 2021.
My dad told me not to. Don't talk to strangers. Don't get in that car with strangers.
No kidding. So he was
Did he have puppies and candy too?
Yeah, I got some candy. He was hesitant, but he got in. I asked him where he needed a ride to. It was about 10 miles away. I found his truck broke down, and he walks to and from work every day, 3 hours each way. He starts walking at 4 to get to work at 7. Wow. Let's help him get his truck fixed. Any leftover money will go to Chicago area food banks, and they have raised in the, I think it's been in a couple days' time, they have raised $10,000.
Wow. Yes! Bravo. Absolutely.
Very, very cool. Wow. Dude, be a nice person. Okay.
Yes.
Enough with the sappy crap. Here's three stories that'll make you laugh. Are you ready?
Ready.
Yes. So ready.
All right. Here's a fella and over there. Here's a fella that decided, hey, you know what? I've got to get my wife or get my girlfriend an engagement ring. The time has finally come. I love her so much. I'm going to stop at no means to get her the ring of her dreams. So he didn't. And he stole her other rings and pawned them off so he could then buy her a ring. A Louisiana man was admitted to stealing and pawning a $4,500 ring, owned by his girlfriend, and then using the ill-gotten proceeds for a down payment on an engagement ring for the same woman. Justin Pope, 29, arrested yesterday for the theft of a ring that belonged to Samantha Futch, 40. Ooh, older woman. Nice. Wow. See, I'm telling
you. Sarah when we need her?
there's a market for you. Yeah, like, Sarah would be so offended. Pope allegedly stole the ring in mid-2019 from Futch's residence. According to probable cause affidavit, Pope yesterday confessed to taking the ring that belonged to then-girlfriend. Pope said, told investigators he sold the ring at a local pawn shop, then used the money for a down payment for an engagement ring for her. The stolen ring was valued at $4,500. The affidavit does not reveal how he was identified as the subject. It took 2 years for an arrest. Deputies has sought to retrieve the ring a month after pawning it, only to learn that it had been melted for scrap. That means it was ugly as sin. The court filing lists separate addresses, blah, blah, blah. He's free on $500 bond. So, yeah, there we go. That fella would stop it. He would do anything for love.
No, that's not how you do it, bud. Yeah.
Including that. Okay.
Yeah.
Next story. don't park your car legally in Florida because if you do. I'm not making you laugh.
You said that we were going to laugh. That's not funny.
Oh, yeah. We were ready to laugh. We were ready to laugh.
You know? A little bit. You really said that like you're like a court gesture. Like you're like, I am not amused. You will make me laugh.
That's funny. That's funny. You know, I wasn't laughing when you didn't show up to your show yesterday. So, you know. So. If I make 7 of your 8 laugh, then I'm okay with it. And if I don't make you laugh, then you do. That's exactly how I want it.
And the laugh.
And here we go. Don't park your car legally in Florida. You could end up like this fellow right here.
Whoa! Oh my God.
And it's not the first time it happened. Back in June, Clearwater police posted photos of a car that had been illegally parked along the Courtney Campbell Causeway, only to become partially submerged by high tide. Well, it happened yet again, ladies and gentlemen.
In the wall.
Always pay attention to signs and barriers that try to keep you from parking where you shouldn't. Someone decided to park this morning in an area where you're not supposed to park along the Courtney Campbell Causeway and went for a walk when the tide came in. This is the end result. A wrecker was waiting for low tide to try to remove the car. It was total. There we go, everybody. Absolutely
amazing. I hope he has good insurance.
Honestly, that's just high efficiency.
He better have good insurance.
High efficiency, low effort car wash. It's fine.
True. True. Yeah. It's good. Listen.
Do you guys think Floridians know that every radio station in the country makes fun of Floridians?
They make fun of Floridians in Florida. I've heard it before.
They're
almost proud of it. It really is incredible.
You think they'd get together, have a meeting, and been like, you know what, guys? We need to clean up our act a bit. We're falling a little low here on level of the rest of the country.
Hell no.
Well, here's the truth of the matter.
When did we have a respect level for them?
The truth of the matter is, it's not a
joy.
It is not a it is not an exclusive to Florida thing. Stupid stuff happens everywhere. The thing is that only Florida has the day. I think they call it the daylight law or like the sunshine law or whatever they call it, where all public records are released. All arrest reports are released. All of them. Not every state. Most states don't have that. So you don't hear a lot about other states. Mm-hmm. Ghost Stag says, just got here. Nice crew today. Happy.
Hi, Ghost Stag.
Ghost Stag.
I will not. I will not say that. But I understand your sentiment. I do love you. Okay. We're going to have one more story in the Floridians category. What?
I said Sean keeping his job.
More you know.
I love it here. What can I say? I love it here. Okay. My phone is ringing. None of your business. My phone is ringing. Imagine. Oh boy. Yeah. Oh well.
Don't worry. It's just the banker, Sean. Don't worry.
Oh, Kyle King. Yeah, Kyle King just called me. There it is. Hold on a second. Kyle King is calling. Let me call Kyle King really fast. We'll get into this last story after this. I'm going to warn you, this next story is probably one of the greatest stories of all time.
Hello.
Hi there, handsome.
Hey, you sexy bastard. How are you?
I'm very good. We're just partying over here at the free-for-all residence. How's it going over there?
You know, we're just partying over here at the house party. It's what we do. Would you like to know tonight's drink of choice?
Oh, sure would.
Yes.
Are you watching? Because we're watching your show right now.
Oh, you're watching my show. Oh boy.
Yes,
should I watch your show?
Should we watch them?
My show?
Watch us.
Showception.
Perception.
You know, Kyle King.
Alex and Kira and Nick and Francisco and Miguel.
Hi, Fran.
Cleave the land is here as well. Yes. Yeah.
Wait. No.
Yes, sir.
Show docking says the radio fan.
Kyle King show. Oh God.
The Kyle King show.
Yeah, I know.
The Kyle King.
We got it. All right, we're
the
here.
Only.
We found it. Oh, I have to watch an ad. Sorry, I'm not subscribed.
Sean.
It's an ad for Disney, though, and it makes me want to go to Disney. So, you know, you can't blame me there. I've got children. I go to Disney.
No, it's horrible.
Right,
jeez. Can't blame you, and I'm going to. What a friend.
Thanks, pal.
Today I decided to go back to, like, my college days. And I'm drinking a 40 tonight.
Oh, wow.
Got Mickey's Fine Malt Liquor.
Ooh, Mickey's.
Hold on a second. The radio fam watching your stream saying that we're committing show docking.
Yes. we are absolutely committing show docking right now. Oh, wow. See, right there. Oh, Mickey's. This thing's bigger. Look at this thing.
A little bit of a delay here. My God.
Wow.
I think anything's bigger than Kyle King's head.
The only unfortunate part was they didn't give me a brown paper bag to drink it out of.
So now you had to screw doing the glossy thing there, and that's a big ass drink there, fella. So what are you doing on your show today?
So we're playing a little Rocket League, and we're also playing Do or Drink. But I wanted to I did something just for you, Sean.
What's up?
And I want you to. So hold on. Let me go to the right screen.
Okay.
There we go. So, all right. Let me know when you see my card. Because you should see Kit right now, right?
No.
I have Kit, too.
Oh, wait, now, hold on. Here it comes. We're delayed. Yes, there it is. Oh, very nice. I like it. Nice. Yeah.
Thank you. I saw this today, and I was like, I'm going to call Sean because I have to. I went ahead and dropped this because I felt like I had to play, in your honor. So here, my friend, is my brand new DeLorean.
Yeah.
Did they release this?
Those of you who play Rocket League, the DeLorean was given away years ago or sold years ago, and then they took it off. You either had it or you didn't. They finally brought it back. So now you have the DeLorean back. It's a beautiful car, isn't it? Isn't it stunning? It really is gorgeous.
That's beautiful. Nice.
It really is. It's nicknamed the Tempesta.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Just for you,
Dan. The DeLorean.
It's even got the Mr. Coffee on the back.
Mr. Say that again?
I said, great Scott. That's all I said was great Scott.
Me to it, Nick.
Oh, okay. That's good. I also had to do a poll on Do or Drink. And so I wanted to see. Let's see. Let me go here. Let me change to this screen.
Oh.
And the card that I have to pull, because Justin just got 1,000 points in a game.
Oh, wow. Nice. Yes.
He's doing big things over here. My car. Oh, Jesus.
Kyle, have you been working out? Look at those guns.
Man, you know what I'm saying? Like, come on. I have been working a little bit. Just a little.
Nice.
Just a little.
Aren't they cute? Kyle and Sean are cute.
Oh, my God. This is gonna suck. Here's the card that I have to do, ladies and gentlemen. Put a tampon in each of your nostrils and leave them there until your next turn. Or drink twice. If no one has tampons, everyone drinks. Well, I live in a house with a girl. Two girls. So, tampon time.
I would totally drink.
Oh, wow. There it is.
There
we go.
Absolutely.
My God. I would totally drink.
What's it going to hurt?
Kyle.
What's it going to hurt?
Kyle, can we just say for a second, while you're unwrapping these, imagine having to live with these on a daily basis. Like, it's like, oh my God. I was like, hey, I need to have one of these because at any moment I'm going to start like absolutely bleeding profusely. That's what a terrible way to live.
It's not fun.
This really looks not. Like the thing that they put in Neo in the Matrix. Remember when they put that thing in his belly button?
Honestly,
applicator, man.
It almost looks like that is the applicator. It almost looks like that little thing that Men in Black used to make you forget what you were doing.
Yes! Oh. Everybody's gonna forget that I did this. Just look right here. Here we go.
All right, here we go.
Oh, God.
Well, no, that's the applicator. No, that's, oh, my God, that's so thick. No, that's not how you do it. That's not how you do it.
No, take it out. First of all,
how do you know?
Because I'm freaking 37 and I know how a tampon works.
Push the tail. No.
Dangly,
you're gonna cut up your nose, Kyle. Oh no,
Kyle!
Okay.
I think you're doing it wrong.
Do you know how tampons work? Should I show you how the plastic works?
Do you understand that the plastic does not absorb?
Do you want to show them how a tampon works?
Like, not physically on your body, no.
Should I go get a tampon to show them how it works?
You're doing it so wrong. No shit.
No.
I mean, not
like no, Samantha. No,
yeah, Samantha. I don't think we're allowed to show that. Samantha was offering to show you.
You know what I mean? No.
That'll get us kicked off of Twitch.
Yeah, we'll get demonetized.
No. Yeah.
Why? And then you're gonna cut up your nose. Then you're gonna need the tampons.
All right. Well, see, what you have to do is you're like, those things you're supposed to push it in from there.
You're supposed to push it until the comes out, bro.
No, I'm not pushing that up my nose. Hell to the... You know what? I should have used this one. Like all that congestion and stuff.
Yeah.
This looks so good.
That would really work.
Why? Why are you doing this?
Okay. Hey, Kyle, let me briefly read you a quote from Carl Sagan. Carl Sagan. You know Carl Sagan, right? The science guy. He had that Cosmos special back in the day. Back in 1995, Carl Sagan wrote a book, and in the book he said this. I'll fast forward a little bit here. The dumbing down of America is most evident in the slow decay of substantive content in the enormously influential media. Lowest common denominator programming, credulous presentations on pseudoscience and superstition, but especially a kind of celebration of ignorance.
Kyle King, ladies and gentlemen, Kyle King.
With that. Okay, I'm gonna play a game so I get these things out of my nostrils.
All right.
God damn it.
Now you know
how I get. If you inserted them correctly, it would be better.
If you put them in your nose correctly, you'll be able to breathe. So just
don't use the applicator, dude.
Yeah, no, do things correctly. Have you ever met me before?
No, I haven't.
Oh, so you keep doing it wrong.
We've seen. Yeah, I love you too.
Have a great day, sir. And hey, listen, I hope you have a low good flow luck tonight. A low flow.
Low flow.
Thank you. I'm going to use these later on if Will ends up in a coma. I'll use one of these later for him.
Good night. Love you, Kyle.
Good night. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, my God.
Wow. You just never know when he's gonna dial in. And my goodness, the Dragonborn, 1, 2, 3. What's up, dude? Hi, hey, I see him. Push it real good.
Oh,
wrestling streams. It's up there, wrestling streams. Thank you so much for the follow. It means a lot. What's 423? Yeah, SummerSlam. We're just talking about SummerSlam. I don't think it's gonna be 100% capacity. I really don't think.
I'm kind of hoping it's not 100%.
Well, I think everyone would like it to be 100%, but I think we're also such a stupid society that we're just going to keep this number going higher and higher.
Yes, just because of the circumstances.
Okay, hold on a second. Revenge of the Chaz is getting very needy. Today's show is brought to you by Chapman Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram at Issa Haram Mojave. Chapman Chrysler Jeep in the Valley Auto Mall and the Chapman Ram Truck Center on Boulder Highway. But no, they're not there anymore, so you have to go to the other Chapman Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram. It's around the corner from the other Chapman Dodge. So many. They don't sell DeLoreans, but trust me, Kyle King, if he was driving, you would not want him driving a Chapman who would besmirch it. Look at how bad he is at this game. Look at just totally whiffed. Oh, wait.
Okay. Oh, no. Oh,
all right.
Oh, God.
That's so funny.
It's a tampon's fault.
Wrestling streams. Oh yeah, I guess he's playing in there. Okay, we do have one more story, ladies and gentlemen. We will. That's the first one, and I will do the next one, Revenge of the Chaz, in mere moments. Do not worry. Okay, one more time. We're going to Florida. This has the makings of being possibly one of the greatest stories we ever tell on this channel.
Okay.
I'm not even going to fly in the lower third because I need you to see it. A Florida man who found himself in a legal pickle after cops spotted a pickle in him has cops to indecent exposure. Eric DeTige, 47, arrested in March by cops responding to a suspicious person call in a Tampa suburb. It's always Tampa. Officers found a pantsless DeTige lying on his back in front of a townhome that was not his own. As memorialized in an arrest affidavit, DeTige, naked from the waist down, had his ween in one hand and a large, uneaten pickle in his other hand. Deputy Armando Fajiju reported that DeTige was using the pickle to penetrate his rectum while he was diddling himself.
Oh, no!
Wow.
That's his mugshot. Maximum pleasure. He looks as though mission was accomplished.
Pictured above, DeTige was arrested for exposure of sexual organs, a misdemeanor. Only a misdemeanor. All right.
Only a misdemeanor.
worth it. He was released on $150 bond, but he was back behind bars a week later after getting arrested on a felony theft charge for stealing a Red Bull in skinny jeans from a Walmart.
Oh, you know.
He pleaded no contest. He was ordered to pay fines, yada, yada. His home, which is in the Flying Cloud Mobile Home Park in Tampa, has multiple convictions for many things. And there is the fella right there. Let's see the memorialized arrest report.
No.
I was dispatched to a suspicious person while circulating the area. I observed the defendant on private premises. While on a private premises, I observed the defendant lying flat on his back, no pants or undergarments on his bottom half. Eric had his ween in one hand and a large uneaten pickle in the other hand. Eric was using the pickle to, exactly what I just said. So there we go.
Isn't that forward?
Joe Quills. Wrecked him, damn near killed him. Cool Fiasco says, look at him brows. Yeah, no, his eyebrows there. You know, listen, he is like the pickle fairy. When you least expect it, he's going to come into your room and here's a pickle. And then what did the pickle have to say after this occurred? God, there's got to be a joke here somewhere. Okay, what did the pickle say after this occurred?
Oh, God, no. No, no.
Well, the rectum line would have been great.
What did the pickle say?
That's where he was sticking it.
I'm asking you.
I don't know what the worst.
God or getting eaten.
That's true.
I don't ever want to go back there again.
It's dark in here.
The pickle was
reset. Eat or get eaten.
Very good.
Well, you know, I think it would be like maybe perhaps the pickle was like, listen, I was gonna be here eventually. So this was always the
plan. Seen some things.
How? Like you don't have to use a pickle. Why? That burns.
That would burn. Yeah, something tells me that would burn just a smidge.
She's just trying to rebalance this pH.
Wait, hang on. Kira just said, wait, you don't have to use a pickle. What should he have been using here?
Well, you don't have to use a pickle.
Yeah, pickles are probably not high on the list of things you would want to use.
No, that is, no,
you probably stole the pickle anyways.
What's high on the list
of things you would want to use? I'm curious.
I mean, they have things that are specifically made for going in crevices. I mean, don't they? Have you ever been to the
It's a multi-million-dollar market.
No. The Love Store? What are you, nuts?
Wait, why do you look so disgusted?
How can I walk into a place like that?
Oh, I was like, why are you disgusted? I'm sorry, am I a disgrace?
Clutching her pearls, I see.
I don't know what you're a disgrace for, just because I don't get into toys.
Yeah, okay.
Your problem is.
I like the real thing. I just want to apologize to all my pickle and cucumber family out there. Sorry for my actions. I loved him.
That would kill me.
That's good.
Joe Quill's teaching us something. You can't you absorb things faster through your anus than orally?
Yeah, I would literally. I'm allergic to pickles, so I would die.
Now we know. We're sick of curious.
But you also love pickles.
Come here. the dill pickle, I mean, frankly, all he needed was a dill of another sort. And then that would have been a lot less gross and weird. Still doing it in public, but people are freaks, man. Wow. People are freaks out there.
That's a lot.
Let's go over here. We'll get this over here. And then we'll go over to here.
Hey, Michelle, are you
We're playing
now?
Games.
Am I what?
Are you amused now?
Yes. I am sufficiently amused.
I have laughed.
Everyone go inside your internal chat here. I just put in the code and you guys will be able to do this yourself because there's 8 of you and there's only one host and there's not enough room. So I'll be the host that goes in the sidelines here. I'm exhausted. Just to let you know, I've only got like 3 or 4 hours of
You're
sleep.
Doing great, bud.
I do apologize if I'm slurring my speech, but I'm trying. Okay. Revenge of the Chaz won't be eating a pickle for a while. Pickles are delicious. I do enjoy a good pickle. I just wouldn't want to eat a used one.
I love pickle juice.
Yeah. Will pickle juice kill you?
Remind me what the website is.
I don't know. I've never
Jackbox.tv.
Yes. Thank you.
Yeah. You would have known that if you were on the show on Thursday when we're live from Boston.
We were on vacation, Sean.
I was on vacation.
I don't know. It's a very special show for us. I'm just really disappointed that you weren't there for what was.
We weren't even home when the show was on.
I'm very sad I missed you. Didn't even like it. On Fremont Street looking at all the really awful.
Honestly, like, imagine Sarah and Stephanie and you. That's why I tried to book you all on the same show, because Stephanie and you, like, you're both total smartasses. It would have been lovely.
I really liked it yesterday.
I'm trying to find the biggest. If you had like the top four biggest smartass women on the show, who would they be? You definitely have Michelle,
Ashley O.
Stephanie's new, but Stephanie for sure.
Stephanie,
I think Marie's got some zingers.
Marie. If it's just the four of you, sweetheart, you'd be taking a thing because you have your moments, but you're too sweet. You just get four of the most freaking poisonous, like, they can knock you down. They're locked alone with that one that freaking night. Right in the heart, they'll get you. God,
I'm drinking like a fish that night.
Like a fish.
What else has changed? Okay.
Where's Sarah in that list?
Swallow. Remember that?
I saw that last night.
Don't forget Sarah. Sarah is too sweet, though. Like, you know, like, I'm not saying that Ashley is incapable of being sweet, but Ashley is like, her default is smartass. Your default is smartass.
They don't give an F.
Yes. They give no F's. Sarah
felt bad about making fun of autism yesterday.
Sarah's still very sweet. She's not jaded yet.
I just cut that clip, by the way. That will be on social soon. Unbelievable. He looks like a dork. Oh, great. Wait till you watch the next 10 seconds because you're going to feel like a total piece of crap. We don't have everyone in here yet, guys. We're missing someone.
I'm in.
Oh.
Wow, Kira.
I didn't push.
All right, Nick, start us off, sir. Night. Here we go.
I know. Thank you. I didn't push play. God. Whatever. Oh,
this is why we can't have nice things.
Are we skipping?
Yeah, we put it in before. That guy, I'm going to end up deleting that quote because that quote is not me. I'm quoting somebody else's quote. So now we're just getting
yesterday, a quote. Yeah.
Who are you quoting? Will.
Welcome to Trivia Night. I just want people to swallow. Apparently
you want to skip my Wow, Sean.
Wow.
Wow.
Wait, that was Will.
It's nice
wow,
to have a
dream. William.
First question.
All right, here we go.
First question.
Walks at a constant speed of 3.1 miles per hour. How long would it take her to walk around the Earth? Also assuming she can walk on water.
All right. Assuming Kelly Rainbow walks at a constant speed of 3.1 miles per hour, how long would it take her to walk around the Earth? I'm going to find this preset and shrink that box a little bit.
Not a clue.
I don't do math.
Math is hard.
Mathematics.
And the correct answer is... Who got the question right?
I just like the numbers. Okay, cool.
The rest of you, I have a surprise for you.
Let me guess, fingers?
Welcome to the killing floor.
Dun, dun, dun.
It's time to express yourself. Oh. And no, this isn't drawful. I'm using it in a totally different way. Sheesh. Your favorite thing to eat. Draw
you guys
thing as fast as you can. Press send when you're finished.
What? Who's going to draw the pickle? Here we go. Can join the crowd here. GRKC at jackbox.tv. And you can join the audience and help determine who wins and who loses here. Favorite thing to eat? I'm just trying to draw right now.
Now everyone gets to vote.
Wait, what is C?
My gosh. Kind of
angry. I know what C is.
Oh, no.
I know what C is.
Is that a piece of sushi?
Yeah, I have made my determining.
The votes are in.
Okay, B is the worst one. Oh, come on. Ah, boo.
It's sushi.
No, the B didn't have crust on the pizza. It was a crustless pizza.
Crustless pizza.
You're a crustless pizza.
Yeah, but there was more pepperoni.
That's fine.
But don't worry. Ghosts love trivia party games, so you're still in this. You haven't lost or anything. I mean, I was a ghost for a while, but I got better. Sure. Here's how everyone's doing so far. It's real early, though, so don't freak out. Oh, and let's see how the audience is doing. Looking at that score, the audience might be dead already.
Oh, no.
All right, here we go. On to the next one.
How many of the 20 different answers that you get from the original Magic 8 Ball are positive?
What?
How many of the 20 different answers that you get from the original Magic 8 Ball are positive?
I don't know.
Well, here's where you make an educated guess.
This.
10.
Half, right? Oh, cool. I just need half and half.
You just, yeah, you're just like, okay. You,
half and half.
You want,
right?
It's essentially there's a coin in the middle. Flipping device.
There's some neutral, too.
Yeah, there's some in the middle and there's some negative.
Well, yeah, but they said the original, so
we're
there we
going
go.
To play chalices.
Chalices.
I've given all the safe players a bit of poison to use.
Ooh.
A chalice to drop your poison in.
The odds are
and
not good.
And meanwhile, the audience can vote on who they think will die.
Choose which chalice to poison.
Bloop.
Now it's your turn Kerplunk. To play. Pick a chalice to drink from.
All right, I'm just gonna die.
Dishwasher safe.
He's dying.
Tasty.
He's dying.
Now let's see what everyone drank.
Uh oh.
No!
Indiana Jones.
Oh no.
Out.
Good job,
wow.
Oh wow, you both avoided it. Okay, I thought it was the other
one. Yeah,
that little freaking cup they put next to him is too small. Can barely read it. On to the next one.
Right,
question three.
Next question. And now on to someone far more nefarious than me. Bill Keane is the creator of which comic strip?
Who did Bill Keane, or what freaking comic strip did Bill Keane write there? Mother Goose and Grimm, Family Circus, Beetle Bailey, or Hagar the Horrible? Hagar? Never knew how to say that one.
I only know one, so...
Who picked this?
Family Circus. Thank you very much. Got that one.
The rest of you who are still alive, prepare for your punishment.
Did.
I'm going to ask you a question. Answer very carefully.
Do it.
Come on, Mama.
What's your spirit animal?
What's your spirit animal?
Ooh.
Rick Astley.
Which, by the way, this is on the list of things that were considered to be insensitive and are banned from Brandeis University in Massachusetts, where they said this is mocking, mocking the Native Americans.
Now everyone gets to vote.
All right.
I want you to pick the answer that you hate the most.
Oh, wow. Somebody answered that. So what's your spirit animal? A puppy, Gilbert, or non-mass offensive? Well, we all know what the worst answer is.
Oh,
yes.
No.
Worst
absolutely.
Answer?
Bye.
Adios, Gilberto.
It was a good run.
Yeah.
Garbage disposal time.
Oh, no. Oh, it's.
Why would you put that? You have to know you're going to die.
Just pick an answer that you don't like.
I didn't. I'm not up there.
Oh, okay. All right, never mind. I thought it was you. Okay.
The votes are in.
No.
There
it was my mother, I bet.
This is where self-esteem
is. I'm not with my mom.
It was a fair try.
I thought it was my mom.
It just was awesome.
Rising above the fray.
Love that. Okay.
Question four.
What letter did author Vincent Wright never use in his 5,000-word novel, Gatsby?
Okay.
What?
What letter did he never use in the novel Gatsby? U, D, I, or E? That's a lot of extra work there.
Hmm.
go with that one.
Time's running out.
Only one of them
Time's
seems
up.
Logical.
No, I didn't vote.
This one.
Oh. Ooh.
And I knew it was that.
Wow. I did not expect E
Let's
at all.
Play a game. You're in luck.
Ooh.
There's a big pile of cash in here. Here's how this is going to work. If no one takes the money, no one dies. But if you do take the money, I'll kill everyone who didn't.
All right, so Nick, ADB, Samantha, and Will.
Money, then you all die.
All right, how's it going to be? Negotiation right now would be good. No, people are making the votes right away. They don't even care.
They don't even care.
Oh,
they should know by now.
Internet went out. Oh, no, that's not good.
Ah! Oh, no.
You're also greedy.
Oh, no.
You're also dead.
Oh, wow. I don't want to be the only one that died.
Bye
bye. Nah.
You're always the only one that dies.
You're always the only one that dies. So Cleveland is currently
down.
Frozen right now.
Out
I'm not sure if you noticed that, but he will maybe join us later. We'll see.
Oh no.
Question five.
What color bow tie does the Pringles guy wear?
Oh, wait.
Nick, you used to be the guy that just fell on the sword for everybody.
I know. Sorry. I'm looking at the group. I'm like, no, I'm not going to die.
I was gone for a month.
No, these people are selfish asses. I'm glad you did it.
This one?
Red. There it is. I had it.
Yeah.
Oh, he's back. Thank God. There it is.
Yay.
Questions for being IT.
Where's Area 51? Well, this should be an easy one for us, or at least practically all of us. Wow.
Wah, 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 wah.
Connecticut.
Cleveland.
I heard it was right. Somewhere there in the hills of the North Carolina. My data
well,
said
this is the fastest we've ever answered.
ADB, do you not know?
Oh, my bad.
There it is, just in time. Nevada! Hey!
I thought it was one of those where it's like the people that did got it wrong. Oh, my bad. I didn't know it was a question.
I think it's time for some.
Now we duel it out. All right, Michelle.
Why are we dueling this out?
Or you could grab some money.
Because the game's over.
Because it's only us.
Yeah.
We're the two left.
It's a boar fest at this point.
Time to battle for my amusing. So, you know, try to do something amusing.
I couldn't vote.
Ooh.
Michelle took the cash.
You feel dumb for defending,
right.
But no one even cared enough to attack you. And if you don't
I don't know what I'm doing.
Story of my life.
You took cash and Kira lost. She didn't get any money and she was defending herself from an attack from you that never came. So there we go.
It's paper, rock, scissors.
Tiebreaker rules over on my
yeah,
website.
It's basically.
Blogspot.
I could really use the traffic. I've been trying to use social media, but it's not working.
It's run by a California Air Force base. Bob, the point you know, it's a good one. All right, how's the audience feeling? Ooh, the audience might win today. Let's see how this goes.
Well, look who's still alive. Now you just have to escape.
Let's go, Mommy.
All right, Michelle.
I'm going to give you a category.
Shut up, Sean.
Ben and Jerry's Fibers. Tap on each answer that fits, then press submit.
What do you think? Ben and Jerry's Flavors is just you, Michelle.
Let's see the right answers.
Really? Oh my god, I got the total opposite.
I guess both.
Toffee Break is such a good name for a freaking ice cream.
It is.
Ain't way too much ice cream.
It's getting real close to
yeah,
the
me
exit.
Too.
Why is this just me?
Oh, did I mention that
well, everyone else
no, we're gonna play
well.
Two.
It's not.
We're gonna
good.
Play
two.
If those catches up to you, then they will steal your body.
Don't freak out yet. You're fine.
Here's everyone's next question.
Oh jeez.
And Ghost
who knows
get a
this?
To help them catch up to you.
Where's Sarah?
Pokemon was just before my, just after my time as a child. I did
up.
Not get into Pokemon.
Me neither.
Man, don't understand it.
My brother did.
Like, yes, I think the did. Last thing that I, like the first thing that came out where I was like, meh, was Power Rangers. I didn't get into Power Rangers.
Me neither.
But right before
hey,
that, like Barney. Barney was like the last thing, like PBS. One, right? I'm just trying to, yeah.
Not a clue.
Time.
Damn.
Not a clue.
All right, here's moving forward. Trivial Pursuit.
Genus Edition categories.
Genus Edition categories. Radio and talkies. Arts and literature. Games and hobbies.
I don't even know that.
Trivial Pursuit.
I don't know what genus edition.
That would actually be maybe a good game for us to play. We could play In Pursuit of Dong.
Dong.
I have friends Trivial Dong Pursuit. I love it.
Yeah, it sounds great. Shenandler Bong. I remember that episode. It was so funny.
Shenandler Bong.
Wolf's friends.
Michelle kind of running away.
She does.
Here.
Yeah.
My mother and my father do. Should be.
Cars made by Kia.
Oh.
I don't know.
Cars made by Kia. By the way, today's show is brought to you by Chapman Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram at East Sarah Mahoney, Chapman Chrysler Jeep in the Valley Auto Mall, and the Chapman Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram around the corner from the other Chapman Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram.
Chapman!
Tell you, we can't find a new Kia. I knew that
one.
Next. Wow, already.
Oh, Jesus.
That was an early departure. Diet Coke ingredients. Soybean oil, vitamin B or potassium benzoate.
I don't know.
I don't know. I don't know.
Do you can't pronounce it. It's probably in Coke.
The topic is contained
no.
potassium benzoate.
I don't know. It was the one you couldn't pick, Michelle. All right, moving forward. Some movement there. Francisco, bye-bye.
Francisco.
Lost to the darkness. Events in a decathlon. 1,500-meter shot put mountain biking.
I don't know what the hell a decathlon is.
It's an Olympic event with 10 events.
It's okay, Mom. I don't know either.
Oh, thanks. That makes me feel better.
What is Gilbert?
There you go.
Damn it.
100% for the audience.
Gilbert doesn't know either.
I didn't do shot put, damn it.
The darkness approaches.
Damn it.
Ironies in Alanis Morissette's Ironic. Good advice that you just didn't take. Getting your new car stolen. Death row pardon 2 minutes too late. Which one is actually ironic? Because that's the one thing about that song is they never really...
None of them are ironic.
A lot of it
None
wasn't
None of them
ironic.
Are really... Yeah. Mm-mm.
Isn't that ironic? That is ironic. A song called Ironic, where most of it's not irony. All right, here we go.
Damn.
Lockley the Land making his move. Might not be in time, though. On to the next one. Bah! Academy Award for Best Original Song. Which one? That Thing You Do, Everything Is Awesome, or City Slickin'? Wasn't, I believe Kyle's Mom Is a Bitch one, didn't it? Kyle's Mom Is a Bitch.
Did it?
The biggest bitch in the whole wide world. Nah. Oh no, it wasn't that one. It was Blame Canada.
Oh yeah, okay.
Blame
yeah.
Canada's Canada. The one that won.
Yeah, oh,
damn it.
Hey,
none of them. Wow.
Oh, I'm out. I think I'm out.
Oof. Bye, yep. Kira.
Bye, Kira.
Yep.
Call of Duty titles. Call of Duty Time
what
for
the hell
War.
Does
Call
that
of Duty
mean?
SWAT. Call
this
of Duty Black Ops.
Round.
This is a video game franchise. Call of Duty titles.
Michelle, I think you win. Oh.
I have no idea.
Just guess.
Sucks to be you.
Just guess.
I would guess.
Literally guess.
There's only one of them.
I think you're gonna win regardless, though.
I don't think so. That's gonna hurt her right there. Oh, she picks
no,
right.
She got them both.
She picks right. Well done. She picked a single one.
You're gonna win.
Mommy won.
Monkeys. Which ones are monkeys?
I don't know.
Now I know where she gets it.
Shut up.
I don't know.
I'm
a poochin.
Sexy.
A poochin.
There she goes, everybody. She's yeah! Now we see whether or not she scored a higher amount than the audience. Because she could lose to the audience right now. Here we go. 12,500. I don't know. I don't know. Audience score.
I lost, didn't I?
Oh! That was amazing. Well done.
And that's double that the
dog. Hell yeah.
No, Mom!
All right. So, 12,500.
Okay, but wait. So that Call of Duty question, I only had, I didn't have Black Ops on mine.
Yeah, because here's the thing. How in the lead, you don't get the third option.
Oh.
Yeah. You only have to choose from two.
Yep.
Then if the third option is the right answer and you don't answer either one, then you get it right.
Perfect. Okay, yeah, because I didn't pick either one. Okay.
What's that on that here? Okay, so now we have to figure out whether or not you're going to play for Double the Dong tonight. So let's figure that out right now. And I think... Let's go to the spinner.
Let's let her.
No, let's not. And say we didn't.
I thought she was alive going into the final round.
Yeah. That's how we do it. That's right.
Yeah. And we win it.
So yeah, you played for Double the Dong tonight. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh, Mama.
Not that I watch this show like all the time.
You remember the rules way better than I do. I'm exhausted. All right, here we go. It's boom. Prediction has started, by the way. Double points. Will Michelle qualify tonight? And we're going to see right now.
Don't even tell me how many people are voting against me.
Okay, I won't let you know, but you'll find out eventually. Okay, here we go. We'll bring this over here. And it's ready to go. All right, over here, and we'll do over here, and we'll go over to this, and we'll hit that, and we'll do this over here, and we'll go bam, bam, wrong one, boom, bam.
Whatever Francisco predicts, what I'm gonna do.
I know what it's Francisco.
Oh, he just went in.
Here it is, everybody.
He just went in on no.
Yep.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Huh? He said yeah. He
as they you! As they would say, they blew his whole wad on you.
I'm sure
we'll get an update. Like, Washington, can we? Really, yeah, we can't get it.
The Matt's bet every time.
Yeah,
because like it's not even fun for him.
It's like
anymore.
It's honest to God. It's like what is money? He's like, this doesn't even matter.
Like
this?
Money? What? Let me just make it rain.
All those lovely ladies wearing an off teal sort of situation. What would you like to name these ladies?
Handbag, because your shirt says the bag. Hmm.
Oh yeah, the bags under my eyes are designer.
Oh, designer handbags. Designer handbags.
Oh, yeah, I like handbags. That's right. Yeah. We'll right, do handbags. See how many I have.
Fleming's menu items.
Do the cheap ones.
Wow, this is perfect. The 26 most popular handbag brands, and we have 26 cases. It's like this. Here we go.
Match made in heaven.
All
right.
Tailor made even.
Beautiful.
Since you just said 26 twice, I guess I'll pick that.
You're going to do 26? Yes, sir.
Hey, Michelle.
Freaking out. Yes, sir.
Can I just let you know that right now, you just have two haters. That's all you have is two haters right now.
Yeah,
two haters that both bet the farm.
Yeah, they did. Five people.
Well, no, you got Francisco who bet the farm, but then you got finding my perfect awkward. Oh. Oops.
Thank you, Will, for throwing me under the bus.
But I want to know why Francisco hates me. You vote against me every single time.
I vote against everyone.
He plays the odds.
I know.
Statistically, he's going to do a pretty good job.
You did my middle finger last night for me last night, so I don't hate you. I'm just kidding.
So now check it out, Michelle. You have Joe Quill, you got Samantha, you got Alex the Barrio, Ken Vange, Guillermo, Revenge of the Chaz. They all believe in you. So you got it. You got this.
That's just how you've been muted. I mean, honest to God, though, what a waste of money that was.
It's for the kids, Sean.
Yes.
It's for the kids.
It is for the kids. That's right. It's for the kids. Very good. Okay, here we go. The ladies are here. You're picking 26.
Forest
Brighton.
Green.
Brighton. Thank you very much, Brighton. All right.
Hold on. Sorry. This just in. The Miz just bet against you. Sorry.
Oh,
that's your normal program.
God, wow. Sure, remember that.
Can I ask, Will, are you at home or are you in town? Or what are you, your setup is?
He's on the lam. I keep telling you.
He's running away. See, he deleted his social.
He's running away.
He's running away from something or someone. He owes someone money. I'm pretty convinced.
I'm traveling for work.
Oh, okay.
He doesn't have his normal green screen.
Someone money. Oh.
He doesn't have his green screen, everything. It's just.
It's awfully defensive, though, isn't he?
I'm sorry that I don't.
He doesn't want anyone to know where he's at.
That's fine. I was just. You're traveling.
We're just pointing out. It's fine.
I'm nowhere fun.
Yeah. Where in the world
is Will Dorsey?
Will Dorsey.
Hey, Michelle, so what's your first case? Where in the world is
Will Dorsey?
Hey, Michelle, what's your first case?
When Sean asks me, I will respond.
Sean, ask Michelle what her first case.
Every time you push me forward, I press the button. Keep pushing it. You're pushing it with your mouth right now. All right, here we go. That's what she said. All right, he's officially he's removed himself.
Oh, you're pushing it with your mouth.
Yeah. Now where is he?
Yeah. The same. All right, here we go. Six cases.
This is very stressful. My baby girl.
You know, I'm gonna be a kid as long as I can because
okay,
really, but you spend like an adult.
No shit.
I learned from my mom.
I make my own money.
I have my own money.
Well, I spend yours.
From mom.
I do spend my money sometimes. I also spend your money.
Yeah, I know.
You're going to make a great wife one day. Six
You're
cases.
Make
here we go.
A great wife. 11.
Boedeker, open that case.
Good start.
7.
7. Burberry, open that case.
I have those. One, I have that.
Ah, good for you. Four cases left.
Timing.
That was awesome. 20.
20. Uh-oh. Hammer time. Calvin Klein. Open that case.
Marty?
Oh, wow.
Marty.
Oh.
Calvin?
Right.
Forget Kira.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Not about to start.
Two. Three cases left.
Fair enough.
13.
13. Chanel. Open that case.
I don't have any Chanel.
All right, that's not bad. That's not bad. That's not bad. Next one.
Relax.
Two.
Two. Did you go to Yale? You okay there, Coffee? Did you go to Yale, or are you collecting
no.
stealing boyfriend like ex-boyfriend shirts? What's going on over there?
My aunt lives in Connecticut, so she sends me a whole bunch of Yale stuff because in high school it was my dream to go to Yale for drama, and you know I'm not smart enough. Or
missed it by that much. Okay.
Sean.
Case one.
No, he's right. Just kidding.
What did he say? One. Is it one?
One?
No, I didn't, but shoot, should I?
Do it.
Why are you asking?
Your case is...
You have to pick a case.
Anytime.
Sean.
Pick a case.
Now I'm nervous.
Jesus.
Oh, God. Now you made everything crazy. Now, okay, five.
You know...
Guillermo says...
Michelle was playing,
Guillermo
not Samantha.
You're already drama, Kira. No reason to go to... What were you going to say?
True.
You know, people do well at this game when they just don't care.
Yeah, she does care a little too much. All right, what case is again?
Five.
Sure. Chloe, open that case.
That's good. Okay.
Yeah.
No sweat off my Chloe? Wow.
There's a purse called Chloe.
It's a brand called Chloe.
It's a designer
like
brand.
Samantha
I don't
know was supposed to be named.
Total porn star name, Chloe.
Thank you, Ryan Pearson. Okay.
Well, because back when she was born, there was a porn star named Chloe. They would call her Mount Saint Chloe because when she would, you know, she would just be the loudest human.
My name was supposed to be Chloe Michelle. So.
Chloe Michelle, yeah, it's a total
even better.
Porn.
When she would what? What is when she would you
when
know?
She would
what
reach
is, you
climax.
Know?
She would be louder than
big
a freight
O.
train. We would call her Mount Saint Chloe. Look it up. Okay. What case?
I will not.
I will later.
Oh my goodness.
Two?
Yes, please.
Coach purse.
I have those.
Not bad.
I do not have a Coach purse. Thank you very much.
Wow. Are you basic?
She's too bougie for that.
I'm too bougie for Coach.
Yeah. Coach is lower level. But I have a bunch of those, so.
Explain that. Hello.
Yeah.
Is there any way I can get in the Yale, but like not get in the Yale?
I had a GPA, but not that good of a GPA, you know? They were like, not good enough.
I want to get in Yale, but I kind of fail, so. UNLV? Great.
Yeah.
Rebels. Hello? Okay, thanks, bye. 37,000 dong, dong or no dong?
No dong.
Bye-bye.
A Yale Community College. Yeah, I don't know. I didn't even apply to Yale. So.
It's called stale. All right, here we go. Five cases.
I could have gotten into that one.
Oh my God. 15.
15. Cole Haan.
So much pressure.
Cole Haan. Open that
Ryan
case.
Ryan has Cole Haan shoes. He hates
Ooh,
them.
Ooh, great.
I bought them for him and he hates them.
Great job. Did you buy it with his money?
I did. No, I bought them with my money.
Okay. But then you just spend some of his money. So it's essentially like you bought them with his money, but you didn't buy them directly. You just bought them indirectly.
Pretty much.
Period. Alan,
that's good.
There's a give and take.
Yeah. See, I didn't spend $150 of your money. See, what I did was the thing that I would typically buy with your money, you'd spend your money on something, the shoes, but then you'd spend $150 more of his money on
the balance.
I have my own credit card when I buy him gifts and I pay my card. Thank you.
Sure. But then like, you know, that was another $150.
But everything else goes on his card.
Exactly. But that was another $150 that you didn't maybe have. So then you would have to spend a little bit more on his card.
But I don't put anything on my card other than gifts for him.
What you did was essentially money laundering.
Yes.
Okay.
But of the legal kind?
Wow. Sure. Mom.
Go ahead. Next one.
It's legalized money. It is. He's right.
Because I have to have this conversation with my wife because we're getting the child care credit there. But it's like, it is it's my tax deduction at the end of the year. Like, so I'm going to owe another $30,000.
I have Crocs and love them too.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah, but I got him Cole Haan shoes and he hates them, but the Crocs he loves. No, okay, so I got that PPP loan. And
you got a PPP loan for what?
Because it's based on your income from
your business of selling Spanx.
From 18 and 19.
Yeah.
And they compared 20 to it and I qualified.
Right.
And so he was asking, so what are we going to do with that money? I'm like, well, I'm going to pay my Lula bills. See?
Okay.
So it's the same conversation that you're having, though.
Yeah, about to have that conversation. It's like, listen, I know you want to spend this on like the kids, like stuff, and but it's like, that's going. I'm going to end up having to pay that on taxes. Like, I'm inevitably, that's going to be I get to deduct.
I don't like this tax credit coming out now.
I do. There are people that need it. That I get it, but like, I don't necessarily need it right now. Okay.
But I would like to defer to, anyway, whatever. What did I say?
You didn't say anything. 21. Dooney and Burke, or Bork.
I used to have Dooney and Burke.
Well, you just had yourself.
Oh.
Big smack in the bags there.
I needed that one.
Mommy. Mommy, you're doing it wrong.
I did used to have Dooney and Burke though.
It's the one with the duck on it, isn't it?
Yes.
This is not a yes or no game. You have to pick a number.
I answered the question about the...
1 through 26.
1, please.
1. Finally got there. Fendi.
So much fun. I have Fendi.
Open that case. I have Fendi. Good for you.
You bougie.
Do you have to get all of your purse straps shortened so they don't bottom out and hit the floor?
Zing!
Zing!
That's from yesterday. All right, 2 left.
Evidently, this is for that. You're waiting now.
I know you're playing.
Dinner at Fleming's was fabulous. Thank you.
So it was worth it. All right, good. Oh man, that was a good one.
So good.
It's one good. Of those things you don't think about until you realize. Wait a second. Okay. 2 left.
12.
Furla. Furla, open that case. All right, Nate, it's not bad though. So listen,
not bad.
One of the ones that you need.
Not in the bad range.
It, then the offer would go up.
Oh, such is life.
You only care about that
other case.
Oh, it wrong.
You're fine.
Sean, that was awesome. Thank you. It was great.
He was proud. Really,
honest to God, I think it should be a service. Like, not all straps fit all people.
More you.
I do have one that's too long. I do have one that's too long.
There it is.
A strap?
Oh, which one?
The one from today with the chain. Can't shorten it because it's a chain.
Oh no. You have a
strap. So I wear it. So I wear it crossbody.
She does. I forgot about that.
She loops it twice.
Yeah. I feel like this is a problem that isn't known about that should be known about. Somebody should start a charity.
We need to bring more light to it.
Sean's strap-ons coming to a store near you. Which, by the way, would be a perfect replacement for that pickle. All right, continue.
If you were wondering.
Sean!
Oh, everything hurts.
Kyle needs you really quick. How do you order your steaks?
Medium rare.
There it is, medium rare. Good.
What a girl, Michelle.
I like you. You know how I order a steak. Go ahead.
Petite filet, medium rare. Asparagus. That's what I had last night. Thank
Shocking.
You.
Go ahead.
8.
8. Gucci.
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 Oh, yeah. Mommy.
Keep it going.
You know what's sad about this whole thing right now, though, is the fact that if Michelle qualifies, Francisco doesn't even care that he lost that money. But, he lost nothing.
Because Francisco's bougie.
He bougie.
You can order yours today at chodes.com. Hello.
Oh my God.
I know what that means.
Thanks, Pike. $48,000.
No, thank you. Oh my God. Jonathan.
Hi, I'm Sean Tempesta, and I'm here to ask for a $150,000 investment for 5% stake in my company, Sean Strap-Ons. Ladies, are you incredibly short? Do you find that your $1,000 purse that your husband bought you inadvertently is dragging on the ground?
It was more than $1,000.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Are you too short for mini golf?
Well, that's where I come in. Hi, I'm Sean Tempesta, the founder of Sean's Strap-Ons. You just strap one on, and all of a sudden, your purse has gotten a little shorter. Where the frick is she?
Where did it go?
No.
Just checking out.
What?
Because, see, it's too long, right?
It's like down in her
so
ankle.
So you just double it. And then probably
see, that would be right up in my arm.
Or you do cross cut. Louis thinks of everything.
Louis. Gracious. You're on a first name basis with Louis. I'm sorry.
There's only one Louis, and that's Louis Anderson.
Louis Vuitton.
Nope.
I'm still at Mr. Vuitton right now because I can't even reach that high. So.
Pick a case.
19.
Oh
God, I'm so nervous.
Kate Spade, New York. Open that case. Ooh.
Mom, okay, I have a pair of Kate Spade shoes.
Sean's crossbody strap-ons. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you have to have multiple kinds.
I got trees of green and roses too.
Louis Armstrong?
No.
Oh my goodness.
Kyle Armstrong.
My life, 24 years!
Wow.
Thanks for joining us, everybody. I am Sean Tempesta. Welcome to the show. A lot of people following us today.
Hello.
I just made a joke about Michelle being really short and all of her purses bottoming out because she's only 4'10" and her straps
11.
Are too long.
11.
It doesn't matter.
I'm 4'10".
11.
Whatever the case is, so we came up with a new idea, and I would sell shorter straps for purses, and we'll call them Sean Strap-Ons. And I have my first two customers right there. There it is. We lost one of our guests to space. He got sucked into a black hole. And that's pretty much where we are right now. We're playing dong or no dong. So what now? What?
Can you make a chain to match?
I like the noise.
There is a Sean strap on for every sensibility. Okay. Kyle King Show says, hey, remember that time I found out live on stream you don't sub to my channel? Good times. Now, I will say this, if I may. If I may, pause that for a second.
You don't sub to anybody, do you?
Here's the thing, Kyle King. If I may, for just a brief moment, please know that the free for all.
That was such a good burn.
The free for all.
That was so good.
The free. Okay, shorty shot. Okay, seriously. The free for all might as well be a 501c3 because all of the bits, all of the subs that we get all go towards either paying out dong or charity. You can attest. We donate 100%. So I have no left. I'm not making any Twitch bucks here. So, you know, it's I got to like cut off something special. My kids got to eat. So, all right, here we go.
Yeah. And,
but I do love you. I want you to know.
Amazon gets their cut too. But
we all are suffering Amazon. Too.
Freaking Jeff Bezos is flying to freaking space because of our freaking hard work, bastard. All right, here we go. Three kisses.
How did I do?
Demonetize me now, you bitch. All right, here we go.
Did you read that Ashton Kutcher was supposed to, but he gave up his ticket because it's not the right time for him and his family?
Imagine double booking space. Oh,
that was this weekend.
Well,
I was going to be in town.
You know what? Listen, trying to get a brunch at Cheesecake Factory on a Saturday is a bitch. So I'm going to have to do a rain check. You're gonna have to take somebody else to space.
Oh my.
So weird. Revenge of the Chaz. Wear a Sean strap on to any event. There's a strap on for every occasion. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Hello. Yes, hi, Savage Grave. I miss you, man. Good to see you.
Colors.
Afro Man Sanchez with a whole bunch of dropping a whole bunch of stuff there. And your kids are more important than the call. Yes, they are. Yep. Even the ones that never made it to fruition. Yep. Even those.
Wow.
All of them are more important than you. It's like, well,
oh, no.
Didn't find the egg, but it was fun. Okay, back to the game. We're playing Dong or No Dong. She was playing for double the dong tonight. She is up for possibility of qualifying for the tournament of dong.
Oh my god.
Ghost X, the story of my life.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Wow.
25. We're naming all of these cases after purses that she loves the names of. She uses her husband's hard-earned money to buy purses for herself. It's hilarious. Okay.
Just let me know when we get to Birkenbag. That's the
long
dream, baby.
Chomp, long chump.
I don't know. Never heard of it.
Long champ.
Yeah. All right.
Not a nickname I've ever received. Longchamp? Never gotten that one. Divadick Sean has 2.2 million kids that could have been called Jack. And that was just yesterday.
They all
died. I don't think this is my kind of show anymore. I'm a little kid.
I want you to
when
all know.
When was it
I
ever?
Delicate sensibilities.
I have a... I have a moment of silence after every time I'm like.
Sean,
sorry,
Sean,
but we have some lovely party for you.
Sean, we gotta play chaps. You gotta play chaps for him. You gotta pour one out for him.
I kind of did already. If you really need to. Oh god.
Oh my god.
It's a Friday show. I'm sleep deprived and I just don't care. All right, go ahead.
Wow.
12. 12? What? You said
9. I said 9.
9.
Louis Vuitton?
That's the one. Louis Vuitton.
Please don't be a million.
You said Vuitton? You said Vuitton. What?
You know what's funny is
Louis Vuitton.
My wife wanted a bag from Louis Vuitton for Christmas one year.
Louis Vuitton.
Back when Peter was born, so it was 2010. So we went down to Louis Vuitton and I asked for an actual bag, not a purse.
Yes. Oh, I didn't know you had that type of evil in you.
I'm trying to find the picture so I can send it to you so you can show up. They gave me one because Peter was a newborn.
That's amazing.
She opened it up.
I saved everyone. Oh my god!
I said, "You wanted a bag from Louis Vuitton? There you go. It's a bag from Louis Vuitton."
What a dickhead! You are the worst. How that? How that hasn't ended in divorce is beyond me. Gotta be honest. That's incredible. Unreal. All right, here we go.
Oh my god! I saved every bag and every box that were on the top shelf in my closet on display. I was so excited.
Awesome. Whoever breaks in your house will be very happy that you kept them, so they can bring it straight to the pawn shop. Okay, here we go.
The paper bag? What's it going to be worth?
Oh, with the other bag. Well, they'll just put it in the other bag. I just bought this last week.
Oh, whatever.
One case left.
Okay, I need a case.
Yeah, that's the
spot. Yeah.
23. 23. I don't know. 23.
Michael Jordan.
Oh, boy.
Mark, by Mark Jacobs. Mark Jacobs?
I don't have any Mark case. Jacobs.
There you go. Yes. Yes.
Hello. It's the sons that never made it to fruition. Hello.
Oh my god. Oh my gosh.
I know I miss laundry day. I know.
Oh.
Sean Tim.
What?
All them socks.
Now you know why I wear flip-flops so much.
There it is.
Okay, there it is. Never use socks. That's weird. Okay, thank you. 88,000. When you see this thing going 88,000 dong, you're going to see some serious...
That's
it?
No?
No, no.
Bye-bye.
Oh.
Somebody just summoned quote 232. I can't get it out right now. Will the treasonous. the treason era was a good era on this show. Okay, here we go.
That was good.
39 people watching.
It wasn't a treason era.
The treason era was not a good era.
Yes, you were.
Attachment unavailable, may be removed, or the person who shared it might not have permission to share it with you. Sorry.
All right. Well,
a lot of that going on in Facebook lately. Okay, here we go. Pick case.
14.
Michael Kors. Open that case.
I have Michael Kors.
Oh my God. You also have nothing but sadness.
Oh my God. There it is.
It's okay, Mom. You still have one more case. You're good. It's okay. You're still alive.
You're still alive, but you need to feel this pain.
Oh.
It's not a good
You're worried
pain.
About me feeling the pain?
It's not good.
Oh. I'm trying not to cry. Mommy, I believe in you. You got this.
Yeah, it's a dong.
It's dong.
It's
not dong. It has nothing to do with dong. I want to be in the tournament.
Plan for double the dong tonight. You're still able to qualify.
It's
got a DM for someone.
I would cry over being in the tournament too. Never mind. I understand.
10.
10. 9 West. Open that case.
Come here.
Aww.
Aww. Namaste.
Hi, namaste.
Happy.
Three.
You know what? You know how like dogs can like smell death?
Oh my God! Are you saying
namaste is like? I think she's.
Are you saying three is the 500,000? I hate you.
This could be it for you.
Oh no!
Prada, open that case. Come on, namaste. Sniff it out.
Does the devil wear it? No.
That would have been awesome, though. What a great clip that would have made.
I have no Prada. No, yeah, it would have been a great clip. Awesome.
Go, Sax.
Oh, wow.
Mr. IDEJ getting gifted this sub. Thank you very much. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Zenobi.
She's very emotional.
Hey,
Zenobi, hey, good for you. Thank you so much, Ghost Stags, once again. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They're still going to go.
She's going for the librarian vibe. Yeah. Okay.
Thanks. I like the bone.
Viper 1874, good for you. And bad for you, your offer dropped by 10,000 dong, dong or no dong. No, dog. Bye-bye. Wow, you mad, bro? Never even seen him, but congrats. Ghost Stags gifting a sub to you. And we have one more, too. My goodness. And it's coming up for, ladies and gentlemen.
Drum roll, please.
Thank you. That's my baby.
My baby.
Samantha.
Sean, I sent you the picture again. Might have come up.
That's it.
No?
Yep.
Facebook Messenger?
Yep, I'm on it.
Huh?
You gonna pick a case or
16. please let me be in the tournament.
Rebecca Minkoff.
Oh, no, it's okay. It's okay.
Rebecca Minkoff, open that case.
I don't have any of that.
Ooh.
Oh.
Okay.
It's okay, Mom. It's okay. That's my girl.
Wow. Put those things away, lady. My goodness. We are not on the hot tub show. We're just chatting. We'll definitely get demonetized in just chatting.
Sorry, I have boobs.
I'm not.
No, I'm okay. Really?
No, I wasn't. That's my daughter, Sean.
No, I'm just happy that, she, you know, listen, as a female, she should have them. I'd say it creepily.
Okay.
I wasn't like, nice.
As a female, she should have them. What about the females that don't?
Sucks to be you.
No.
You set me up. I have got to do it. God gifted you with something better. A posterior.
An ass?
Oh. Yeah, an ass. Yeah.
In all the ways, yes.
All the ways, yeah.
Yeah.
I tweeted it at you now.
Oh, no, boy, I'm getting all angles.
Cheater. Always. You let me know.
Whenever you're ready.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yes, Nick. Oh,
Salvatore Ferragamo.
Salvatore, I don't have Ferragamo. That either. Please don't be 500,000.
Ooh, it's $400.
Oh, no, that's very close. That nice. Is.
By the way, this is the Louis Vuitton line. Bag he got for his wife. Literally just the Louis Vuitton. I love that. That is just another level of cruel, and I love it.
That's so mean.
Hello?
That's hilarious.
She asked for a Louis Vuitton bag. What she got?
I mean, you're not wrong.
Specific.
Okay. All right, thanks. Bye. $50,000 dong. Man, your dong is shrinking faster than, dong. So. Dong or no dong?
No dong.
No dong. Bye-bye.
Oh, my God.
This next one's really exciting, so go ahead.
22.
This is a brand called The Sack.
Oh, I've seen The Sack.
Oh, it's my favorite.
I've seen The Sack, too. It's quite a brand. The Sack. You know, the one thing about The Sack is it's often ignored.
It's a tragedy, isn't it?
It really is a tragedy.
It's a tragedy. You
know? The sack is
so
great.
Things I would like
more
to
people
say.
Should pay attention sack to the sack, good. Yet no one does. It's very sad.
Oh, so much I want to say.
Samantha, yeah. Boom. There you are, a subscriber with your mom's money. Yeah, I know. The Sack, open that case.
No.
1-0.
Very close.
I saw the 5 and I got so scared. Oh my God.
All right. Just a brief reminder, by the way, if you have Amazon Prime and you have a Twitch account and you're not using your free sub, feel free to connect your Amazon Prime to your Twitch to make Twitch Prime. You give us the free sub, whatever you want to do. Again, the
That's
leftover money
do.
Does not go to me to enrich myself, and despite the fact I spent all this freaking money on the system. It all goes to either the contestants or to charity. Hello.
Or maid services.
Okay.
Massage parlors.
Trust me, mine doesn't look any better. It really doesn't.
Yeah.
Thanks.
It's a streaming thing.
Kyle says it also doesn't go to me either. Well, yeah, no, it goes to her because. Gotta keep her happy.
Littering and.
Okay, next bite.
Littering and.
60,000 dong. Dong or no dong?
No, thank you.
Bye bye, no dong. 1 case this round.
Oh my God.
Oh, Jesus.
God, I'm so nervous. Four. Damn it. I don't know. 4. Oh.
Ted Baker.
I don't have any of that either.
Ted Baker. Let's see if you have any of that Tournament of Dong.
Nice.
Hey!
Nice. Not the same thing as the last one.
Kyle King Show says, I literally love Sean Tempesta. When I see you, I'm going to open mouth kiss you. I want you to know that.
Tongue and everything.
Oh, God. Wow.
That was sexy.
That was a lot.
That was a lot.
I'll be your prince. 103,000 dong. Bye bye.
Singular.
One case.
Six.
Six.
What are you doing? Did you just lick your microphone?
I did not, no. Tori Birch. Tori Birch, open that case.
Nice.
Wow. Michelle!
I know, right? She's doing amazing. Yeah, she's at that point where she's really stressed about a fake game show that plays for her.
I just want to be in the tournament.
Yeah, sad, isn't it?
She's glad she didn't go to dinner tonight. Throwing up that dinner from all that anxiety.
Sorry, was Wendy's closed tonight?
Okay. I made dinner tonight, thank you very much, and it was delicious.
What'd you make?
I have to ask the rest of the family. How was the food?
She didn't.
Shows you.
So you would just have to ask the boys.
So delicious.
Can they drive you?
Well, Kate has a license, but he won't drive.
So she's the only one that could escape and did.
I was already gone.
I am an excellent cook. Thank you.
She is. I love her cooking. For reals.
147,000 dog.
For realsies.
Darn, no doubt. No,
blink twice if you're in danger.
Gilbert, blink.
Well, one case.
Oh, God. I'm nervous for you.
Oh, come on, Mama.
17?
Yes, please.
Vera Bradley.
My mom has one of those.
Vera Bradley. That's great. Good to know.
I know.
Vera Bradley.
Just don't even open it. Just give me the 500,000 and double it and let's call it a night.
Honey, I'm not your husband. I don't just give you money for no reason. Got him. All right, here we go. 17. Vera Bradley. Here we go.
Oh, or nothing.
Pity, pity.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
Oh, God.
Yes, hello.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Yeah, she's freaking the frig out right now. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Hi.
Yeah, I know they're hooker nails.
I know they are. They're horrible. Yeah.
Do you use the three seashell boat?
And you're missing one.
Are you missing
one? I am missing one.
Yes, she is.
Wow. Classy. Yeah.
Her entire nail broke. Like down.
Yeah, my
to the
entire
pit.
Nail broke.
It's disgusting. Don't show it. Oh my God. Why would you?
Why? We're supposed to have dinner tonight. What are you doing?
No. No. No.
There's no bag in there. Just went everywhere.
Disgusting.
Just gonna get everywhere.
No. Yeah. I did it very wrong.
Why did you show it? You don't.
Cause YOLO. Why not?
Cause YOLO.
That's not a YOLO moment.
Yo do.
No,
as well.
No, it's not.
You know what YOLO means.
You do that again.
Yo no.
No idea.
Yo fast.
Does Michelle have 500,000? Come on.
Everything
is
going to
be your
I'm
case.
243,000. Dong, dong or no dong.
Oh.
Oh yeah. Is it you or Will?
Go Stacks. Honey, I'm not your husband. I just don't give you money for nothing. Very good. It was locked and loaded. God in heaven. You know, like high school me that took 10 minutes to come up with comebacks would be so proud of like 37-year-old me. Okay. Yeah, 26 and 24. 26 is what you picked. Training anew.
Will's case versus your case.
Michelle, stick with your case.
Fossils.
I don't know. Someone just fuck. I don't.
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
Look, we've gone through this before, Michelle. We have done this before where you didn't pick your case and then it bit you. Well, it almost bit you. Like, just stick with your case.
Okay.
And then you can blame Will.
And that's going against his case.
Yeah. 100%.
He's going against his own, so.
We're sticking with 20.
I don't really even want to. Oh my God. I just want to be in the tournament.
Well, we're going to. You are. You might be. You might be.
Doing her best. Man show. Cut to commercial break. Girl jumping on a trampoline.
I'll jump on a trampoline if you give me the $500,000 case.
No, you'd back out of it.
Jokes I can't make.
I'll do it right now.
Just like the hot tub.
Today's show is brought to you by Chapman Dodge Chrysler Jeep, Ramity, Sarah Mojave, Chapman Chrysler Jeep of the Valley Auto Mall, and the other Chapman Dodge truck.
Hello? Hello?
There's also a Jeep and a Chrysler. It's right around the corner from
Maserati.
Right.
It's different
we're
every
all
time.
The dealerships right now, so it's kind of like all over the place. But just know, you drive on the east side, you're going to see a Chapman. And you go inside and you tell them Sean sent you. They're going to say who? Just to say, whatever, never mind. I need a car. Okay. Nice. That is some bondage
in
right
case,
there.
What's okay.
Wait, what does everybody think she should?
We could run a poll. I mean,
show hands. Who thinks she should switch? Who thinks she should switch?
This is
great. Let's just do it. Let's just pull. We're gonna do this. We do. We love torturing you. 26. If it has 500,000 in it, you qualified for the tournament. If it doesn't, we laugh hysterically.
I know.
Blame on Will.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Here we go.
Get your beeper button ready.
Oh no. Will? Oh no. Oh no.
Oh no.
The kids.
Francisco strikes again. Thank you, Will. And he's gone.
Wait, right. I got a lot of money. Oh, hi.
I'm sorry, Mommy. I love
Please
you.
Please don't cry.
Love you too. Go away.
Please don't cry.
Go away.
Oh, that woman is dumb.
Last night.
25,400 dong in USD is $1.10.
You just go ahead and keep that for the kids.
Oh, very sweet. Thank you. Very, very sweet.
Water on the rock.
Water on the rocks. That guy's amazing. Oh, that guy's so good. Okay, so now that we've done that disgrace, let's go around the horn. We'll say goodbye to everybody, and then we'll find somebody to raid. Okay, everyone. Hey. First of all, it's Kira. Hi, Kira. Great to have you, as always.
Thank you. I love it. Love you.
Wow, oh, thank you so much. Very sweet. There she is, everybody. Michelle Pearson. Wow, a rebel gaming. Matching your dollar. Actually, he didn't even match it. He gave you an extra 10 cents because he's just that rich. Francisco Castro.
He felt bad for going against her.
Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, I did.
Keep
he
the
does
change.
Not feel bad. Keep the change.
There's your mini me. Still our Tournament of Dong champion. There he is. The Daniels.
Well, good night, everybody. Have a good weekend.
Cleave the land.
Thank you.
We'll see you next time. He finally joined us on a Friday. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Alistair. And finally,
he's already asleep.
I was born, so I'ma stay. Ah!
There he is.
somewhere in the world. Ghost Sax, thank you for the bits, buddy. That's very sweet of you. Thank you so much. I really don't push the bits very much on this channel, so I appreciate it very much when you send them in. Thank you. Okay, let's really fast go over to the old Twitch machine here. We'll find some rando. It's hopefully a total strange individual. Wait, where's Will?
A total train wreck.
He's there. He's just very quiet.
Where's still the music? Are we in the elevator?
He was asking for the button.
We're on Twitch.
Let's see here. Well, let's go to browse.
Where in the world is Will Dorsey?
Let's see what we got here. Eat with Vic Eagle. What? Thank you so
much, Jane. 300.
What is she doing?
I seen it the other day.
Oh, she's doing yoga moves
in her kitchen.
All right, let's see what
else we have. Did she just say, I seen it the other day?
Whatever. Listen, if that's the worst you hear today, we'll be fine. Besties getting drunk. Oh, here we go. The girl's wearing little cat ears. After this commercial for the Nintendo Switch. Warrior.
Embark on your journey to save Zelda.
Is this a Zelda commercial or the movie The Wizard?
Save Zelda.
Master the way of the sword to defeat evil and conquer dungeons in a world.
It's Rach Ryan. She has 24,000 followers, but only 51 people watching. Your destiny awaits. Okay, we know. There's a Sarah's sword. All right, here we go.
Rated everyone 10 and up.
So excited. Super.
Yeah.
Wow.
People on years. Twitch are so thirsty. My God.
Is that okay? Is it anybody else?
How many subs does she have? Just so I can like hate myself.
She does dance so awesome. Thank you so much for asking. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
I mean, I feel like maybe
$12.99.
Maybe we should teach them the way of Dong.
Sure.
Let's see what happens.
Seriously?
Let's see what Tell Me Why gets us here. Oh, this freaking vocal fry that was killing me. No, just check your phone.
Yeah.
Okay. And by the way, more viewers than us. More viewers than us. Disgusting. Next.
Wow.
I'll wear a low cut shirt next time.
Oh my goodness. I mean, like just you see what wins here.
Me too.
Now, Hunter Ray, she seems like she's having a day in this photo here. She said, what a day. All right, here we go. Let's see what Hunter Ray's got going on.
Why does she have bondage on her cartoon?
I know, that's interesting, huh?
That's not bondage, that's anime.
I'm telling you. Hurry up, David.
Tell me why.
Hurry up, David.
Her keyboard's loud, too.
Yeah.
She's clearly having an issue.
She's moving to L.A. Good for her.
What even is this?
Is it L.A. or Louisiana?
I'm going to look it up later.
What even is this?
On my computer.
Okay, well, she seemed... who let the dogs out?
Puppy!
Ryan just got home.
Quarter roll hunting. Oh, this is so interesting. Okay, guys. So here's what this guy's doing right now. He is going through...
Plugged in? I want to make sure.
He is going through rolls of quarters to try to find real silver quarters.
Yeah, Mr. Charger's plugged in. Mr. Charger's great.
It's so interesting.
All right, we're good.
This is interesting.
It is. You'll find some old coins and they'll like get a roll that's only worth like $20, and it'll be worth the coin itself.
There was one $200 case and one $500,000 case.
A W on a quarter right here
would have qualified
from 2019 and 2020 is worth $20 and up.
See,
I'm looking for
so
my 17th one.
$20 just for the one quarter. So we just get and literally it's zero risk because you get the quarters. And if you lose, you have 100% of your money. So literally all you can do is break even or profit. There's no losing. None other than time. And obviously that guy has a lot of time. Okay, next one. Schoolgirl cosplay. Oh, wait a second. Hold on. We have to see what's going on.
Oh, Lord.
It's looking funny. Yes, I'm assuming he clipped an N-word troll. Like I said, I do a lot of streams where I bring in viewers and sometimes I say the N-word. If you clip it, you are getting permaban on my channel.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, that's probably good policy to have. Okay, we're continuing. Anna Comics, we vibe and say hello. She only has 9 viewers, according to this. Oh my god, like, just like, enough with the basic white girl listening to rap too loud with terrible audio mixing. Ugh, yuck. I'm sorry, just like a billion of them. There's so many of them. It's disgusting.
Wow.
Yo, chill out. It's Friday. 10 viewers. Is this guy filing his feet? Oh my god.
Okay, all things He's considered, finally. Though, it's not bad at all.
Okay, no.
It's pretty bad.
It's pretty bad. Again, what Driving was that Carl Sagan quote again from earlier? It's Carl Sagan quote.
About the dumbing down of America?
Wow, a little bit. Looking for a daddy. Oh, wait a second. She's looking for a daddy. What? The wild Yesterday. Latina.
I already hit it. John, no. I already hit my car.
It's freaking hilarious, man. Is that a...
It's just so disgusting.
It really is interesting. Thick Welcome body paint. Please
find someone funny.
Scary Cheese. I like that. That's a good name. Hold on a second.
Oh, also, Kenny, welcome to the stream. Kenny, welcome to the fucking stream, dude. How you fucking doing, dude?
I think we've been here before.
Jesus.
He's aggressive.
That was a lot. 107 viewers and he had no shirt on.
I guess no.
That was a lot.
The Hosted Rose. Oh, 5 hour energy. This girl says, if you're not British, I don't want you. Okay, so we're not British, but maybe she'll want a raid at least.
Samantha, tell Brandon.
For what it's worth, just remember that this is we're going into the deep depths of Twitch, as you say there, the Miz on Air, the depths of that we see, the depths of hell, really. sometimes we capture absolute magic.
There are hundreds of websites for 18 plus content.
Good song.
And Raja Twitch requires you have
Listen to good for you.
For it to actually
Listen
be like
to good
a
for
hot
you from Olivia Rodrigo on Mix 9.1.
Tell me why a kid's pool. That's disgusting when you think about it, because they're using it in like, I guess, sexual like way, like, but it's for children. And the people that watch it, and it's just weird.
Kind of like her.
Prepare to be entered. Here we go.
Oh, jeez. And DMCA.
We have raided. Yeah, we're definitely DMCA, so we're raiding quick. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Prepare to be entered. Aww. Free for all show. Thank you for the raid of 25. I appreciate that. Thank you so much. Welcome, raiders. I can't believe I got that though. The best hot tube streams are the bathtub. What? You gave the right answer. Thanks. Olivia Rodrigo, yeah. Hello, raiders. Thank you so much for the raid, free for all show. I hope you had a good stream.
We did.
It's actually gonna end soon, but it's okay.
That's fine. I just want to see what she responds to Dong.
Thank you for the follow, Sansa.
Aww.
Yeah.
I almost appreciate Jesus, though.
Yeah.
It's so loud. I appreciate the fact she doesn't have all the graphics and she's just her streaming as a human.
Maybe you never get it all. Maybe I'm okay. Auto crank hot tube.
Whatever. Enjoy that, everybody. Have a great night, and we'll see you Monday. Bye.
Bye.